going on, everybody? It's Tori, and I'm back with my second trade idea video. Now, I'm slightly behind on this video. I wanted to get it out yesterday, but it's coming out today. In this video, we're going to look at one trade that I think would be a great trade for three teams involved, including us, and it's based on some stuff that's happened recently in the NBA, and I'm also going to look at some of your other trade ideas. In future trade videos, I will probably come up with two, three, maybe four trades. I'm just waiting for more rumors to start popping up, because usually I'm going to try and base my trade ideas off of relevant NBA rumors and NBA news. And with that being said, let's jump into my first and only trade idea. As you can see here, this is a trade involving us, the Washington Wizards, and Oklahoma City Thunder. We get Otto Porter Jr. as well as Jeff Green, who we absorb using the Noah Vonleh traded player exception. Oklahoma City gets Alfarouq Aminu, which they absorb with a traded player exception, and they also get Myers Leonard. And then Washington gets a combination of Patrick Patterson, Alex Abrines, Caleb Swanigan, Wade Baldwin IV, as well as our 2019 lottery protected first round pick. Now for Oklahoma City, they have Jeremy Grant, who's been great at the power forward spot, but they really have no depth there. They got Patrick Patterson, who hasn't been good at all this year. Bringing in somebody like Alfarouq Aminu makes sense from a depth perspective, as well as a guy who they would probably play a bit at small forward. You could play big lineups with Paul George at the 2, Alfarouq Aminu at the 3, and Jeremy Grant at the 4, and all those guys are very good defenders, and all of them are switchable. And offensively, that lineup wouldn't really struggle like you'd expect. Oklahoma's making a legitimate playoff push, so they definitely value a player like Aminu who could help them do that. They swap out Patrick Patterson's 2-year, $5 million a year contract for Myers Leonard's 2-year, $10 million a year contract. In this scenario, Washington would likely want back the smallest amount of salary possible. That's why they get Patrick Patterson instead of Myers Leonard. Myers Leonard makes sense as some depth at the center position. Maybe he could play along with Nerlens Noel. He'd be kind of their fifth big man, but he'd definitely have a fit in that lineup as a stretch five, playing next to Russell Westbrook and Paul George. For Patrick Patterson and Alex Abrines, that's a pretty good deal. They do take on some salary and they are far over the luxury tax. That'd be the reason why they might not take this trade, but they've shown that they don't really care. They're just trying to win. For Washington, they get back a pick for Otto Porter's contract, and they get back expiring contracts other than Patrick Patterson's $5 million a year, which will expire the year after. In an Otto Porter trade, I think Washington will be looking for three things. One, to be able to shed $7-8 million a year so that they're able to get under the luxury tax. Two, they're probably going to want a first round pick, and three, they're going to want expiring contracts that aren't on the books any longer than this year. This trade accomplishes all three of those things for the Washington Wizards. And then for us, we get Otto Porter Jr. to slot in at that starting small forward spot, and then we get Jeff Green, who's a lot like Alfarouq Aminu, as a very versatile defender that can play the power forward spot, that can hit threes here or there, and he can also make plays off the dribble. He would replace Aminu in the lineup perfectly, and you could either have Mo Harkless start as a small ball four and bring Jeff Green off the bench, or you could start Jeff Green. Since Otto Porter Jr., Maurice Harkless, and Jeff Green can all play the small ball four, it kind of offsets losing Myers Leonard. It kind of offsets losing that big man depth. I would like to see us go out and sign a guy like Willie Reed or somebody like that who could give us some depth at that center position. But I think this is a great trade and would help Portland take that next step. If you haven't already seen my Otto Porter trade video, I will link it in the description down below. That's a video that I talked about a month ago where I said that I really want us to pursue Otto Porter Jr. in a trade like this. Of course, news broke that John Wall was having heel surgery and is out for the season. That broke a couple days ago, so I think the Washington Wizards, while they were looking to try and recover from that bad early season stretch and try and grind their way into the playoffs, now I think they might finally be ready to trade some of their rotation players, especially Otto Porter Jr., so they can save some money and get some cheap young assets. Mo Harkless, Jeff Green, and Otto Porter Jr. are all very switchable and all can guard positions 1 through 4, so I really like that combination of forwards. And then Otto Porter is a terrific three-point shooter, shot over 43% from the three-point line the past couple years, and he struggled a little bit this year, but he's finally getting his percentage back up to that level. He'd definitely take our team to the next level, and he could definitely be that reliable scoring wing threat that we've needed for so long.